6.
Also, right now, engineers and inspectors are trying to figure out why huge chunks of debris and concrete fell from the 30th floor of the World Trade Center.
While no one was hurt this morning, many people fear more dangerous materials may continue to fall from the building, causing more damage to people walking by at the foot of Canal.
The high-rise building is more than 40 years old and has been empty for years.
Someone could have been killed, and I wonder if it happened once, if it could happen again.
This is the massive pile of plaster, concrete, and metal that fell from here, the 30th story soffit of the downtown landmark.
Look at all of that that fell, and look how far it fell from. Crazy.
The former World Trade Center president says water, wind, and age likely are factors that brought the concrete down.
They had some previous damage to the lower soffit, and we had that repaired, and we had that upper portion inspected, and that was given a clean bill of health.
And a shock to people walking by who think it could have been worse.
It's a dramatic loss of material. You just don't normally see that. It has happened in other downtown buildings of a similar age, but for a large section like this to come loose, yeah, that's a surprise.
The city sent out an inspector and an engineer to figure out what happened and why.
When I see the report and I can determine what those things are and what mitigation measures we need to make, I can make that statement. But at this point, I'm trying to wait for the information to come to me and make the decision on what it is that we and the World Trade Center need to do to make sure the building is safe.
Well, the city owns the building and nearby parking lot, but does not have full control of the property until issues with the lease are worked out.
Two young children.